Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I am here to do a reading for Capricorn. This is for Capricorn Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. And this is for the month of June, so we are just going to see what comes up for Capricorn for June. That's where the card landed. You see it? Right there. Tortoise. This is it, huh? Slowly but surely getting ahead. That's right where you're at. And you're going to keep getting there because slow and steady wins the race. Rushing causes accidents, right? It does. So you're in a good place. You are getting ahead, okay? So you're getting there slowly, but whatever it is that you're, wherever you're going, you know, where you're going towards success, you're going towards the win, right? You are. And that's your way, right? You go slow, but you get there. When you get to the top, you've reached the top, and that's where you're at, while the other one has lost track. You know, they were rushing, they were in a hurry, they've gone off course. Not you. So anyway, what do we have for Capricorn? Angel protection. So you have some sort of angelic protection here. You are protected. Keep that in mind. There's angels around you. I have to show you what's on the bottom. You have an opportunity in the palm of your hand. This is basically the Ace of Pentacles. You've manifested something. This is a golden opportunity. It is huge. This is long-term success. This is something permanent. This is something you can take to the bank. This is a gift, a blessing, something that you asked for. The answer is yes. This is stability. It is the gift of stability. So yes. The answer is yes, you are going to get there, and you have the opportunity. It is in your hand, and I feel like you are headed in the right direction. Congratulations. You're going to be making more money, I think. There's something to do with money here, an increase in abundance, a new investment perhaps, could be a new job, an increase of money, stability, security. Could be even getting a gift, maybe even for some of you an inheritance. This is like a windfall, could be a win, whatever. And it is a win. You're gonna win. You're winning. You are winning. You may not seem like you're winning, but you are. Emperor. Emperor is an Aries. But it could also be your energy. This is a taking charge, taking the lead, being put in a position of authority. Or you have somebody around you that is giving you an opportunity. This could be a business owner. You may be working with somebody that is very experienced. But I feel as though you're taking charge. You're taking charge. You're bringing order to your life. You are taking the lead. I feel as though you're in control. You're taking control, making decisions that are best for everybody involved. I also feel like you do have somebody around you that maybe it's a boss or it's masculine energy. You have somebody around you that is maybe investing in you. Could be a father figure or somebody that is very prominent. This is somebody that is a business owner or in a managerial position that is helping you in some way, sees something in you. There is definitely some angel protection. You are going to be getting ahead. You are going to be in a very good position in the future, but there is obviously some struggles. Let's get one of these. Because things aren't happening as fast as you'd like them to be. You know, they're not going as fast as you would like. But like I said, slow and steady wins the race. Showing no weakness. You need to not show any weakness. And be ready. Be ready at all times. And I think that you are ready. You're in charge. There is also somebody. I think there's also another person that is helping you. And I don't know where that's coming from, but they want to invest in you. Somebody wants to invest in you. Protection. Oh my goodness. You have, and this is a protector as well. So there's protection here. We have protection basically three times. We do. I mean, these are all cards of protection. So there's some sort of protection here. Something to do with a fatherly figure or a person that is in a position of authority. You could be put in this position of authority. There's definitely some protection here. I see the two swans. So I think that we also have a partnership here. Love, maybe. You maybe have a very protective partner that is coming into your life. If you're single. If you're not single, you may be with somebody that is a protector. They are going to protect you. They want to protect you. They're going to stay with you. They I don't know, maybe it's love with those. Whenever I see two swans, I think about love, okay? It's just the way it goes. I'm looking for my book. I'm going to read that protection card. You definitely have some protection around you, somebody that is going to protect you. They want to protect you. This is somebody that will fight for you. They will do whatever it takes to protect you. The warrior goddess stands on the threshold between two worlds. Above her head, a halo shows divine consciousness. As she guards the mysterious kingdom behind the portal, a golden sword implies readiness for action. The creation of the sword is also a metaphor for life as it passes through the four elements, fire, water, air, and earth, to become an instrument of precision and beauty. Like the sword, we too must pass through the initiations of life, which test our mettle in times, our mettle in times of adversity. Two regal swans symbolizing the element of light stand proudly at protection's feet. Swans also symbolize love, which I knew that they did, as they are loyal creatures that frequently remain with the same mate for years. I think you are attracting a mate. There is a mate here. Or if you're with somebody, you know, there's a mate. Anyway, let's keep going. The light of the sun and the moon reflects the qualities of yin and yang and transcends the alchemy of opposites. By drawing this card, you can feel blessed in the knowledge that protection is at hand. Try to discern why this card appeared today and observe its position within the spread. This will help define which areas are in need of awareness. You know, I feel like you're going to have to wait for somebody. Slow and steady. Things are happening slow. There is protection here. You have a protector here. You may be worried at times, but if everything is going to turn out, it's going to go in the way that you expect it to go. It may be happening very slowly, but it's happening. There is a mate here that is, you know, it's a yin and yang. It's the missing piece. It's the other half, right? Anyhow.
Perhaps you have been feeling vulnerable or victimized by the world around you. If so, be mindful of your thinking, as your thoughts can attract darkness as well as light. Your experience of life is a reflection of the quality of your thoughts, which drive decisions, actions, and consequences. Draw inspiration from the symbolism represented by the sword. The blade has the power to sever ties that bind you to toxic attachments, relationships, behaviors, or situations no longer serving your highest good. On a practical note, keeping your immediate space organized, clutter-free, and clean is an effective way to protect your psychic energy. Be receptive to any guidance given during your meditations. Courage and strength are both virtues that help sustain us through the uncharted waters of change and transition. As the universe lights your course, be open and ready to act on any clues. So you're going, there's some, you know, there's angelic guidance here as well. So there's some sort of angels around you. They've brought in you some sort of protection. You are being protected. They may be bringing you in a protector. There is a protector here. Definitely. I feel like things are not moving as quickly as you'd like, but there's a reason for that. Maybe you're being protected. Maybe you need to go through a period of observation before you run, or something is happening. There is a mate here. This is a perfect match. There is light. You know, you're being guided by angels in a certain direction. There's going to be hurdles. And I think one of the hurdles is time. You know, this is taking too long. It is what it is. It is what it is. Sometimes the best things come to those who wait, right? It's true. Anyhow, I do believe that things are going to progress for you. They're going to keep progressing. You are protected in some way, and if you're not, you're going to be. What do we have for Capricorn? We have somebody here that may seem as though they're rigid. They say that seem like they're rigid, they're distant, you know, but I feel like this person doesn't want to show any weakness. You know, they have a tough exterior. This person is very wise. They're experienced, okay? They have mastered their emotions. You're dealing with somebody that is a master of their emotions. This person is a protector. They're very, maybe they're a perfectionist. They are very defined in who they are, and they want to do the best for everybody. This is somebody who considers everybody in their decisions. So I think that you're dealing with a decision maker who sees something in you and is going to help you to progress in some way. But it's slow. Strength reversed. That's in the past. King of Pentacles. Ten of Cups. Two of Wands. Six of Cups. Ace of Swords reversed. King of Wands reversed. One more. We need one more before I go any further. Investment. Should you invest? I feel like you're waiting for somebody to invest. You're waiting for an opportunity. You've got an opportunity. Okay, the opportunity is coming. It is going to be given to you. So just keep investing. I feel like you are thinking about something. You're thinking about whether you should invest, whether you should wait for this, what should you do, should you do something else, should you go someplace else, should you keep nurturing this, should you keep communicating, should you keep going in this direction. I feel like you're stuck, you're at a crossroads, you're indecisive, you know, is this worth it? This has to do with a relationship where there's a lot of familiarity. This could be a soulmate connection of some sort or something like that with the Six of Cups. I feel like you're thinking, you know, is this worth it? Should I cut this out? You know, should I stop communicating with this person? I feel like you're dealing with somebody that has low self-esteem. They have low self-confidence, even though they project themselves to be very, very strong. I think at times there's weakness in this person. This person may have some anger issues, you know, or some father issues even. Maybe their father didn't take care of them, or their father abandoned them, or something like that. I also feel like you're dealing with somebody that doesn't like to give away their power, doesn't like to give away their control. They like to be in control. They like to be the boss. So that might be an issue that you're dealing with during this time. I feel like you're dealing with somebody that doesn't communicate very well on a regular basis. And I feel like maybe they're protecting themselves. Maybe they're protecting themselves from getting hurt. I feel like there's some sort of weakness here. You're dealing with somebody that is having a hard time opening up. I think this person is having a hard time opening up. There's some sort of a need to let go. I don't know if you're dealing with a Leo, or maybe it's another Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. There's a need to let go of somebody. Somebody has control over you. You know, they like the control over you. You know, they have no respect. They have no respect for others. Something to do with children. Interesting, because this is children. There is children here, and there's no respect for others. This is not practical, not responsible, doesn't want responsibility, doesn't accept responsibility. Somebody that is doing something illegal. You know, I feel like you have somebody that is against you. They want to control you in some way, but I think that you are protected from this person. So just beware of that. And I feel like happiness is in the palm of your hand with that Ace of Pentacles and the Ten of Cups here. That's extreme happiness with a soulmate. I think that, but I feel, and I do see a mate here. So there's definitely a soulmate here. I think that you have an opportunity, a golden opportunity with a soulmate that you have been indecisive about. And maybe it's because of this person that took advantage of you, that, you know, controlled you, that made you feel like you weren't good enough. Somebody here feels like they aren't good enough. They have low self-esteem, low self-confidence, low self-value. I don't know, you know, a lack of value. I don't know my value, but I feel like there is somebody here that does see your value. This is somebody that will protect you and sees your value. So anyway, I think that you should continue to invest in this person. I think it's going to be slow going, because I feel like there's a lack of openness, there's a lack of clarity, there's a lack of communication, and I feel like you need to continue to focus on the future. Do not let this person that has control issues hold you back. And I feel like you're afraid to let yourself be vulnerable. You know, you need to let go of your own control issues. Release the need to control. Just go with it. Just go with it. Let go of the control issues. Because there is control issues here, and there's a lack of confidence and self-worth and feeling inadequate and doubtful, and I don't believe in myself. Believe in yourself. Have faith in yourself, okay? Let's keep going. Hierophant, commitment. Believe. They do this for me all the time. This is about believing. Believe. Have faith. Have trust. That card is a faith and trust. You need to have faith and trust in a higher power. Listen to your gut. You have an opportunity to invest in something that could lead to commitment. If you're already married and things have been a little off, say you're married, you're in a coupled relationship with somebody, and I don't know, there could be some unfaithfulness. I'm just saying, the King of Pentacles in reverse is unfaithful. So is the King of Wands in reverse. There's somebody here is having a hard time controlling themselves. And it's because they have a golden opportunity in their hands. Memories of love are going to be reawakened. Things are going to get better.
You need to commit yourself. You need to commit yourself to opening up in some way. Do not let the past hold you back. There's something in the past that is holding you back. I think it's somebody that didn't respect you, that didn't treat you right, that controlled you. This person was unfaithful. They weren't real. It wasn't real. They weren't being genuine. And I feel like you keep reminiscing or romanticizing this person. The relationship you had with that person is holding you back from a commitment that is real, per se. King of Wands reversed is somebody that is unreasonable, that is conceited, not communicating. There's somebody here that is not communicating. They're not telling the truth about a situation. They're being unreasonable. Could be a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, and you're thinking about what you should do. There is a higher power involved here, that this is a higher power, a direct connection to God. There's somebody from a past relationship that has made you not realize your value. Six of Swords reverse, not going anywhere, refusing to take a new approach, stuck, troubled. Somebody is very troubled. They don't know what they want to do. They're stuck. They're stuck in a situation. They're thinking about relocating. They're thinking about a commitment. They're thinking about marriage. They're thinking about, you know, the connection. But they're stuck. They're really, really, really stuck. There's fear of change here. There's fear of change. And they're choosing the safest option. Somebody is choosing the safest option. Oh, they're trying to avoid uproar, trying to avoid upheaval and disruption, but they can't. This is an unavoidable change. The reversed is a fight, a permanent loss, a painful change, a moving. Somebody may be moving. They never saw it coming. This is a sudden move. Relocation. There could be a sudden relocation here. We could have some illness as well with the Strength card reversed. Somebody may be sick. There is some sort of protection. Somebody is being protected by an angel or angels, and there's going to be some movement. There's going to be a major disruption. We have somebody here that has been dishonest. They haven't been taking care of things because they haven't been taking care. I don't know if it's their health or they haven't been taking care of something. They're troubled. This person is false. They lie. You're going to win. Somebody else is going to win. We have a win here. We have a win. Yeah, and I feel like you're going to win. There's a higher power involved that is protecting. And I don't know if it's innocence, because there's innocence here. Somebody's innocence. Ten of Cups is about spiritual blessing. It is fulfillment, emotional fulfillment, a commitment. Somebody is going to be guided, and definitely guided. They're going to be guided to a, it's like they're guided to a better place, but they're in a situation that is built on a false sense of security right now, built on a lot of lies. But there's so much fear. There's fear. We have fear. We have fear. We do. There's fear. Fear of change. Fear of moving, fear of not being accepted. But there is going to be a disruption, a major disruption that changes everything. This is unavoidable. I know other readers are going to pretty it up and say, oh, that means it's avoidable. Oh, fuck no. It's been avoidable up until now.
It's not avoidable. It's time to go. It's time to move on. We have somebody here that isn't healthy. It's time. There are a situation. It's a false sense of security. It's not healthy. It's very troubled. There's a lot of trouble. There's no growth. It's time to go. It's time. It's been time to go. It's leaving. Somebody's leaving. They are leaving. It's reluctantly leaving. This is refusing to wake up. But there's a rude awakening coming. There is a rude... Somebody's about to get a rude awakening. They did not take care of something that they were supposed to take care of. And they're about to get a wake-up call. It's a sudden departure, perhaps, or a sudden arrival with that Two of Wands reversed. Very, very sudden. Extremely sudden. Anyhow, I don't know if this has to do with a father or what. We have father twice. But we also have the highest authority. The Hierophant is the highest authority, but so isn't the Emperor. But the Hierophant is higher than the Emperor. Guidance. Somebody is going to be guided out of a false sense of security, out of a situation that is unhealthy. And they're going to a better place. There is some sort of universal protection here. You have an opportunity. Somebody's getting a gift. This is a gift. It actually is. It's a blessing in disguise. I think that we have an individual that's going to get themselves in a predicament where they get themselves into trouble. They get themselves into trouble. It may have something to do with their home. Could have to do with their health. This is trouble.
This is trouble right here.
Government could get involved as well. We have government a couple times. So we have somebody that needs to really control their emotions, or they could get themselves in trouble. Two of Swords is a painful, stressful decision. Somebody has been ignoring. They have been ignoring the truth. They've been in denial. They've been torn in two different directions. And it's time. It's time to make a decision. And I feel like the universe is here. There's a higher power that is here that is going to force something. They're going to force a decision. They're going to force a change. This is a forced change. It is. It's time to go to a better place. It's time to move on. Somebody has been stagnant long enough. I feel like we have a lesson that is being learned. We have somebody that has been hanging on to something, that sacrificing themselves, wasting their time, trying to prove that they made the right decision when in fact they did not. They're going to have plenty of time to think about it. Somebody's going to have plenty of time to think about it, because I feel like the government's going to get involved. I don't know if somebody could end up, I don't know why I want to say this, but I feel like somebody could end up in jail. Anyhow, Two of Swords is blocking the truth, ignoring the truth. Needing to make a painful, stressful decision to, you know, see it for what it is. Somebody has been hiding something. But you can't hide from the higher power. There's about to be an uproar. I feel like you're dealing with a fire sign that is going to cause some sort of commotion or cause some sort of trouble. And things are going to, it's like fireworks. But I feel like you are protected. You don't have anything to worry about. I feel like you're going to be receiving some sort of gift from whatever this is. One more card. As they're falling out. There's going to be a falling out. There is going to be a falling out. Lovers, separation, the end of a contract.
This is a conflict. This is a disconnection. It's a detachment. This is a separation. So there's a separation from a false contract that leads you in a new direction. Good luck.